Hey everyone, welcome to my fourth video on rolling codes. In the first video, we did an introduction to rolling codes and looked at security 1.0. That second video, we did KeeLoq protocol. The third video, we did replay attacks against three different devices. And in this video, we're going to look at the rolling flaws application I wrote for the Flipper Zero. Rolling flaws is a KeeLoq receiver that lets you test different attacks. We're going to be doing a demo of lots of different attacks using a second flipper. And I recommend you watch the previous videos first so you understand all about rolling codes and KeeLoq. Let's get started. In my past videos, I warned you against replaying or fuzzing signals on devices you care about, such as a vehicle or a door. In this video, we're using the rolling flaws application, which causes one of our flipper zeros to act as a receiver so we can try all kinds of different attacks with our second flipper. I recommend you use this application instead of testing against a real rolling code device. So for the first demo, we're going to try a replay attack. I'll go ahead and launch the rolling flaws application on the right flipper. And then we'll go ahead and configure. I'm already on 43392. That's good. I'll go down to transmit. On the other flipper, I'll load sub gigahertz. And we'll go to frequency analyzer. Now I'll go ahead and hit transmit signal on the right flipper. And we can see we're at 43392. And then we'll go ahead and go to read raw. And we'll say configure, put a little RSSI threshold, start recording. I'll transmit a signal again. Okay, and we'll stop. And then I'll go to receive signals. You can see that currently it's closed. And it's listening, and we don't have any RX packet yet. Now we'll go ahead and do a transmit. There's that RS packet. And then the door is still closed, and it says that the code is from the past. Okay, for this next demo, it's almost the same. We're just going to go back, and we're going to go to configure, and we're going to say replay attack yes. So that enables the receiver to have a replay attack flaw. So now we're going to do our receive. And we're going to go ahead and transmit that signal again. And this time we're opened. And the reason is replay. So there you go. We did our first attack. For this next demo, we're going to show how to just do a normal synchronization with your flipper. So you've got your receiver and you go in and you say, I just want to synchronize it. And then over on your other flipper, you're going to go to sub gigahertz, add manually. You'll choose that door on 433 and forgotten access is the name it's chose. That's fine. We'll hit save. Nope, that one exists. Forgotten access 4. We'll hit save. Okay, there we go. And now that's saved. So when you go into saved, you'll see this forgotten access 4. You could say emulate. And then when you press the OK button, it's going to send it. And so now our receiver is synchronized to that. So now if we go to receive signals, you'll see it's currently synced. Our count is at 5. And then I'll go ahead and send the signal. Our count is at 6 now, and it's opened. 7 now, and it's opened. So now it's just acting as a normal receiver for our Flipper Zero. For this next attack, I updated my firmware to the unleashed firmware. And what that's going to let us do is we can go into sub gigahertz and we're going to do read. And this time in unleashed, they understand how to receive and send rolling codes. In my readme, I talk about how you could do this with official. But I think it feels like a better demonstration. So let's go ahead and we'll go into rolling flaws. And we're just going to go ahead and transmit a signal. And there's that signal. And now we'll say receive signals. And then over here, we can go into the details and you can see we can save that or we can send it. And you can see the current count is at 1, but when we hit send, it updates it to 2 and it opens. And so when we hit send again, it updates it to 3 and it opens. So because it knows the manufacturer key, it's able to continue to send the next codes in the series. The original remote, however, if it sent that next button, it would have been a 2 and the original remote would now be out of sync. So for this next demo, we're back on official. I'm going to go ahead and launch rolling flows. I'm going to go ahead and send some signal. Doesn't really matter. Just trying to get the count to be non-zero. And then over here in saved, we're going to open up a count that has 3E90 as our code. There it is. And of course, the serial number matches the serial number that we're trying to receive. And so you can see our current count is at 1. When I go ahead and transmit this 3E91 code, you can see that it's now saying the future is 3E91. And then when I go ahead and transmit it again, it's 3E92. It sets the count, advances it to 3E92 now. The original remote is totally worthless. And it says we opened it. And it advanced it because we were within that gap. And again, you can see in the configurations for the app, you can set how big is that future window. So we have it set to 32,000 or 8000 hex. And the gap is the count and the next count have to be within 2 of each other. You could even tighten that down to 1 of each other if you wanted to be really strict. So this next demo is a little scary. It's called a rollback attack. And basically what the flaw is that the receiver has a window future of all, which means that every code that gets received is considered a potential future code. So we're going to go ahead and go read raw. And we'll configure our RSSI threshold, hit record, transmit a signal. There's a signal, we'll save that off, we'll call that 1. And then we'll record a signal, transmit a signal. We'll save that off, call that 2. And then just so you can see, I'm hitting transmit. There's a transmit. There's a transmit. And there's a transmit. We don't actually need those codes. Exit that. So we go to receive. We can see our current count is 5. And then we'll go in and load that first signal, that raw signal we saved. And we'll hit send. So we have no idea what the protocol is, what the serial number is, any of that. We just hit send. And you can see that that's a future code, and the future is a value of 1. And then we'll go to 2, which is the next code we saved, and we'll hit send. And you can see we opened. So those 2 codes that we were able to record had a small enough gap. They were 1 different from each other. And so it opened. So for this next attack, I've dubbed it the KGB attack. And basically the idea is you send a different manufacturer than the original. So in this case, I'm going to send the KGB manufacturer instead of whatever that original manufacturer was. So if we go into receive signals, you can see that I'm on KeeLoq using some custom protocol. And my current count is EC04. And then here I have a KGB Subaru code. And my count is EC10, so it's pretty close. And I'm going to go ahead and send that code. And you see we get an error of bad manufacturer. So that's good. That's what we want to have happen. However, in some remotes, they're universal. Or some receivers, sorry, they're universal. And so instead of the protocol being KeeLoq custom, it's KeeLoq all of the codes that they know about. And so in that case, when we're receiving it and we send that KGB attack, we get an open. Great. Well, thanks for watching this demo of the Rolling Flaws application. If you have ideas of other scenarios that I should add to the Rolling Flaws application, please let me know. You can reach out to me on Discord or you can just leave a comment below. Please like and subscribe. Thanks a lot.